So a monarch butterfly is a big, beautiful orange and black butterfly that can be seen in a lot of places throughout North America. And when I get to go out and watch butterflies, it's just so wonderful to see how beautiful life is. Butterflies are really interesting, and they're in trouble. Most species of insects, including monarch butterflies, are rapidly declining and vanishing. And so how do we save these beautiful species that we all know is part of the biodiversity that makes the Earth function? There are so many things that are fascinating about monarch butterflies. One is that they're long-distance migrants. They go from North America, north of the U.S. border, which is where we are now, into Canada, and they come south and they go all the way to a mountainous region in central Mexico. All along the way, they need food, they need rest areas. Without them, they face habitat loss and death. So the Niagara River Corridor is located in the Great Lakes at the eastern end of Lake Erie, and it is just where all the water flows and where a lot of life flows and relies on. What's really changed a lot in the last 100, 200 years, though, is that humans have had an impact as they've urbanized, as they've industrialized, as they've hardened the shorelines. Well, this whole area is called Times Beach Nature Preserve, and we're located in downtown Buffalo, right on the edge of Lake Erie and the Niagara River. It's a beautiful little green jewel amongst an urban wilderness. Well, for a long time, this site was used as a contained disposal facility for the Corps of Engineers when they were dredging the Buffalo River and the Buffalo Harbor, and it filled up with toxic sediments. When they discovered it was toxic, they closed it. And so in the 70s, a bunch of people, including myself, came along and said, well, there's a lot of birds that are visiting here. There's a lot of insects that are here. There's a lot of butterflies that are here. Why don't we try to reclaim it and make it a nature area? The monarchs, which have been coming here more frequently because of the rest stop that we've provided, have sometimes come here in numbers of thousands. So the Pollinator Conservation Association has a mission to conserve pollinators. We create resilient shorelines, we create living shorelines, we create habitat. It helps protect human life as well as the life of the flora and fauna that we depend on. We work collaboratively with a lot of institutions, whether they're government agencies, not-for-profit organizations, or educations of higher learning. The University of Buffalo works to help inform us with research about things like tagging butterflies, looking at the size of the monarch caterpillars, counting the number of eggs, seeing where they're laying eggs, and basically measuring their general condition.
Oh wait, yeah, look at. That's an egg.
Ooh.
Oh yeah, there is some more.
Really?
Three eggs right there.
Research is so important. Without research, we really don't know what to do or what we've done. People can do a lot of things to help. Starts with being aware. Going outdoors, experiencing nature, doing what they can to protect nature. Use more native plants. Native plants are so fundamental to the success of the life of so many pollinators. Since the beginning of time, it can be argued that the culture of humanity has been to defeat nature. We're at a point now where we've just about done it. In order for us to survive as humans, we've got to learn to live with nature, work with nature, and help nature to support us. We have to find ways to work together to make sure that we have a future.